Looking at the areas of the HFM screen, first of all, within HFM, we have a view pane. And the view pane is made up of application tasks and also task lists. And hiding down at the bottom, we've also got favorites. So any type of document can be added into our favorites area. We can have application tasks where we can see all the types of documents that the system allows us to work with, and we can see all the different types of tasks that we have security access to. Obviously, working with the application tasks, we can navigate to any type of task, and via the documents or manage documents, we can navigate to any type of document, for example, a data form. And I can open a data form here, and I can see here's the P&L summary. So from the application tasks, we can navigate to all the different types of documents and tasks that exist within HFM, though we do need to navigate through the folder structures. And this is where task lists come in. Task lists can be built by the administrators to help our end users work through a methodical, logical list of documents and tasks. So here we can drill down into phase one, and the user will open the headcount data form. Then they'll open the P&L summary data form, and then they can run a report. They might then go into process control as a task. But the task list is offering our users a simple way of navigating through all the documents and tasks that exist within HFM. As part of this course, we're going to have a look at all the tasks, and we're certainly going to build all these types of documents and also task lists. Another key area of the screen is over on the right-hand side. We have filters. So here we can apply a filter for the types of document that we might want to look at. If I go to process control, this area on the right-hand side of the screen is displaying options, determining what will display in this main area that we call the content pane. So bear in mind, HFM is just full of documents and tasks, and we can navigate to them using application tasks, or to help our end users navigate to the documents and tasks, we can create task lists and offer them a logical and simple way of selecting the documents and tasks. Any document and task opens on its own tab in the content pane. And obviously we can close tabs just to free up any resources that we might be using on the server. Then the other area of the screen is over on the right-hand side where you've got your filters or options. And do bear in mind, you can hide the panels and the panes by clicking these little buttons to restore pane. You can maximize the size and get rid of what's called the masthead. And sometimes down at the bottom, you do also have a legend. So this legend is showing me the various status flags and color codings in process control. Again, if we go to documents and open the P&L summary, this also has a legend. So for new users, the legend can be quite useful. As you get more comfortable with HFM, you'll probably not use the legend too much. But the key areas of the screen, the view pane on the left-hand side, and obviously on the right-hand side, you have options and filters, and you can remove these panels and panes by collapsing them and restoring them.